कर दिया। सो रिस्पेक्टेड रुद्रता जी, शिवानी जी एंड इन ऑल दिस वुमन पावर दे आर मेड टू सिट इन बिटवीन। वन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग जर्नलिज्म, वन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग पॉलिटिक्स एंड इन बिटवीन बोथ ऑफ देम फोर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स सिटी। सो विद दैट विल स्टार्ट दिस डिस्कशन। हैप्पी आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स। टुडेज टॉपिक, मेजर पोर्शन ऑफ टुडेज टॉपिक वाज अबाउट हैप्पीनेस। मैडम वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट हर शख्स परेशान क्यों है और वो हैप्पीनेस कहाँ पे खो गया है। सो आई थॉट लाइक विशिंग यू इन सम हैप्पी मैनर। व्हाई टू विश ओनली गुड आफ्टरनून, टू विश हैप्पी नाउ, हैप्पी आफ्टरनून। दिस इज हाउ वी विश ईच अदर इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। हमारा जो ऑफिस है गुगल का, उसमें हम लोग इसी तरीके से विश करते हैं इच अदर, हैप्पी मॉर्निंग, हैप्पी आफ्टरनून एंड हैप्पी इवनिंग। यू नो व्हाट, फॉर यू टू विश हैप्पी मॉर्निंग यू हैव टू फील हैप्पी फ्रॉम इनसाइड। यू कैन नॉट विश हैप्पी मॉर्निंग टू एनीवन विद अ सैड फेस, यू नो, फॉर दैट यू हैव टू फील हैप्पी फ्रॉम विदिन। एंड ऑफ कोर्स आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट वन ऑफ द सैड गाइज इन आवर ग्रुप, जो हमें जन्म से एकदम उदास चेहरा लेके आता रहता है, यू नो, वो एक sadness, जब भी एनीथिंग एक्साइटिंग हैपेंस अराउंड उसके मुंह में कभी देवदास का चेहरा है, राइट? एंड नाउ प्लीज डोंट लुक टुवर्ड्स मी। हैप्पीनेस हैज टू बी द लाइफ, बट विद दैट व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन ऑफ जीडीपी, वी डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट 20 मिनट्स। फ्रेंड्स, व्हेन आई डिस्कस अबाउट दिस जीडीपी, आई डोंट वांट टू डिस्कस इट इन अ वेरी टेक्निकल complex finance terms and all that, because I know a lot of you are not from finance background, so we try to keep it as simple as possible, you know. I don't want it to sound it like the definition of machine in the movie Three Idiots. How many of you remember that scene? American and the Profession? Almost everyone. Look, this is the beauty of finances, you know. I mean, ye shifting hai na, koi revision nahi lagta hai, koi homework nahi lagta hai, koi discussion nahi lagta hai, it's just like I remember all these things. I'll just offer this topic for interest, and I'll just ask two questions to you. Let me know how many of you remember, know that. How many of you know the name of son of Peri and Saif Ali Khan? Where does Virat Kohli's and Anushka Sharma's marriage happen? Who is the latest couple that has got married in Bollywood now? What is the economy of India? ये तो कोई मूवी में आया नहीं, वी नेवर डिस्कस दिस इन मूवी, बट दैट इज व्हाट आई लाइक अबाउट ऑल ऑफ अस, यू नो, आई मीन दैट एनर्जी हैज टू बी देयर, दैट मस्ती हैज टू बी देयर। सो आई ट्राई टू पुट दिस जीडीपी इन एज सिंपल एज पॉसिबल। आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस वर्ड, एट लीस्ट दैट इज जीडीपी। दिस इज जीडीपी इज ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट, राइट? व्हाट इज जीडीपी? जीडीपी आई पुट इट इन अ वेरी सिंपल टर्म्स, मॉनेटरी वैल्यू ऑफ ऑल द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस्ड in an area in a given time. Simple as that. Monetary value of goods and services produced in an area in a given time. So in an area is what? So for example, area GDP we calculate. We calculate Maharashtra GDP, or for that matter we calculate Nagpur GDP in area and in a given time. So we calculate GDP for a quarter or for a year. So it's as simple as monetary value of goods and services produced in an area in a given time. You know, I'll tell you a few interesting facts about Indian GDP and Indian economy. Today, we are already sixth largest economy, right? Where the other developed countries are struggling to achieve growth rate of 3-4% of GDP, we are easily reaching up to 7% of GDP. You know, in first quarter of this financial year, 1920, we got 8.2% as our GDP rate. 8.2%, I think that's a remarkable rate. Developed countries are not able to achieve 3-4% of it. You know, all the big businessmen across globe, they are interested in coming to India and investing in India because they believe in the growth story of India. You talk about Microsoft, you talk about Google, you talk about Facebook, all of them are interested. Just to give an example, Boeing, an aircraft manufacturing company, they have manufacturing facility only in California and Europe. In the whole world, they have manufacturing facility only in these two places. Now, apart from these two places, these people are coming in India, making investment in India, and manufacturing, starting their manufacturing in India. You know, the whole world is is looking towards India for next 15, 20, 25 years. They are believing in growth story of India. You know, this week Standard Chartered International released a very beautiful report. Very exciting and interesting report. You know what they say? Till now, we were knowing that India is 6th largest economy, and they were saying that India is going to become 4th largest or so. Very soon it will become 4th largest. But Standard Chartered International is of opinion that by 2030, 2030, India will become 2nd largest economy. India is going to become 2nd largest economy after China. And the best part, even exciting part, is that India will cross even US economy. India will cross even US. Tell your dear friends, US, who on the basis of our economy leads whole world, dictate terms to the whole world, and we will be crossing them. But 2013, it's just 12 years from now, 10 years from now. That's the beautiful side of Indian economy. And I'll tell you the other part, why these people, why these big business houses believe in India's growth story. I'll give you this another part of it. And that's very exciting for these students also. Friends, in the world, there are three types of countries. Developed countries, underdeveloped countries, and developing countries. Right? Developed countries, can anyone give me an example of developed country? US, Europe, Australia, UK, these are the developed countries. Developing country? India. We are a developing country. And underdeveloped countries are those? Pakistan is the most underdeveloped country we all like. You know, where the even basic minimum facilities are not available, developed countries, these are underdeveloped countries. Now, what economic history says is, in any kind of country, whenever any transition happens from lower type of country to higher, I mean underdeveloped to developing or developing to developed country, whenever this kind of transition happens, huge economic development is in store in that country. And friends, India has already moved towards, the transition in India has already started happening from developing to developed country. India has already started moving from developing to developed country. And this transition doesn't take in 1 or 2 days. It doesn't happen in 1 or 2 days. It takes anywhere between 15 to 30 years. But whenever this transition happens from developing to developed countries, there are lot and lot of economic development, infrastructure development, research and development, lot of new avenues, lot of new opportunities comes up. You know, I normally tell all the students wherever I go, you people are luckiest generations, because in the next 10 to 15 years, the kind of opportunities you will have over your career, the kind of business opportunities you will have, those were not available anywhere since the last 70 years of independence. You will have those opportunities. Subject to you make yourself ready enough to grab those opportunities. Subject to you make yourself able enough to grab those opportunities. Coming back to our topic of today, friends, GDP versus GDH, gross domestic happiness. Right? What is more important? Friends, I mean, there is no doubt in probably anyone of us mind that happiness is certainly required at the end of everything. All human efforts. जो भी हम लोग करते हैं, जो भी मेहनत करते हैं, जो भी एक्टिविटीज करते हैं, उसका एंड हैप्पीनेस और पीस में ही होना चाहिए. एनी वेल्थ क्रिएशन दैट यू आर डूइंग शुड एंड इन हैप्पीनेस एंड पीस. यू नो, इवन द हैप्पी पीपल ओनली कैन क्रिएट अ ग्रेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, क्रिएट ग्रेट रिजल्ट. देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट, नो डाउट अबाउट इट. यू नो, जो आदमी सिर्फ पैसे के पीछे भाग रहा है, खुशी नहीं देख रहा है, पीस नहीं देख रहा है, एक हिंदी शायर ने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से उसके बारे में कहा है, इंसान भी क्या चीज है. इंसान भी क्या चीज है, दौलत कमाने के लिए अपनी सेहत खो देता है, दौलत कमाने के लिए अपनी सेहत खो देता है, और वही सेहत वापस पाने के लिए दौलत खो देता है. जीता ऐसे है जब कभी जीता ऐसे है जैसे कभी मरना ही नहीं है, और मरता भी ऐसे है जैसे कभी जिए ही नहीं. राइट? नाउ दिस इज व्हाट happens if you don't look towards the happiness. It is certainly required, but here I want to make a different point. Here I want to give a different perspective to you. Right? Can happiness be achieved without having money in your pocket, friends? Can happiness be achieved without having money in your pocket? अगर कोई आदमी को दो दिन भूखा है, उसके पास जेब में पैसा नहीं, तीन दिन से कोई रोटी नहीं खाई है, can you think about happiness? If someone in the family, close relative of yours, is not feeling well, there is medical emergency, but you cannot take it to a doctor because you don't have money in your pocket, can you think about happiness? It's difficult. it's challenging to us, you know. And friends, in India, we are going through a different condition, right? And here I'm talking about ordinary people. Ordinary people, जिस चीज़ का रोटी कपड़ा मकान आज भी उतना important है, ये necessities खत्म होने के बाद ही ना वो खुद के happiness के बारे में सोचता है। I'm not talking about the sadhus or monks, you know, जो सब मोह माया से मुक्त हो गए हैं, correct? कुंभ मेला चल रहा है, correct? I'm not talking about those people. I mean, ये साधु लोगों के लिए क्या है? उनके लिए रोटी का भी जरूरत नहीं, फल खा के जिंदा रह सकते हैं, कपड़ा के हैंडी भी है, you know? मकान पर दे वो हिमालय से मकान, पूरा हिमालय का मकान है, सुपर आई नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दे, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑर्डिनरी पीपल जिनके लिए रोटी कपड़ा मकान जरूरी है. फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इन आवर कंट्री वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ स्ट्रेंज इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशन वेयर वन डे वी आर गोइंग टू बिकम लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी. देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड पर कैपिटा इनकम. पर कैपिटा इनकम मींस इंडिविजुअल सिटीजंस एवरेज इनकम इन इंडिया, पर कैपिटा इनकम. एंड यू नो व्हाट, इन आर इंडिया, अपने देश में हम लोग पर कैपिटा इनकम के तौर पे 1,00,000 रुपया साल का ये फिगर तक संभव अभी पहुंचे हैं. सो पर कैपिटा इनकम इन आवर कंट्री इज 1,00,000 रुपीज पर एनम, राइट? दैट कम्स टू 8,000, सम 8,000 रुपीज पर मंथ, राइट? एंड दैट इज ऑन द एवरेज पर कैपिटा इनकम. सो आज भी बहुत सारा हिस्सा अपने पॉपुलेशन का ऐसा है जो 30,000 to 40,000 रुपीज पर एनम इसमें कमा, इतना पैसा कमाता है. सो व्हाट डज इट मीन, इवन लेस देन 100 रुपीज अ डे, एंड इन दैट 100 रुपीज ही हैज टू मैनेज हिज रोटी, ही हैज टू मैनेज हिज कपड़ा मकान, एंड देन ही कैन थिंक अबाउट द हैप्पीनेस. यू नो, दैट इज द स्ट्रेंज सिचुएशन वी आर गोइंग थ्रू एज ऑफ नाउ. नाउ टेकिंग इट टू ग्लोबल पर्सपेक्टिव, ग्लोबल पिक्चर क्या है, यू नो, nowadays countries have started measuring their progress in the terms of happiness index. Apart from GDP, what is the happiness index? Forbes magazine every year publishes list of happiest countries in the world. Which are the happiest countries? So happiest countries as of Forbes magazine latest report is, say for example, Finland, Iceland, Denmark, Norway, Australia, New Zealand. These are one of the happiest countries in the world. They say people living in this country are very happy, you know. And how this happiness index is being measured? On the basis of their earnings, on the basis of their living standards, employment, medical facilities, on the basis of higher average life expectancy rate, right? These are the two criteria on the basis of which happiness index is being measured. Friends, we talked about per capita income of India, that is 1,00,000 rupees per annum. Do you know the per capita income of these happy countries? The per capita income of these happy countries ranges between $45,000 to $75,000 per annum. Now, to put it into Indian rupee terms, friends, the per capita income of these citizens of these countries is around 50,00,000 rupees per annum. 50,00,000 rupees per annum. Why will they not be happy? I mean, there is no reason otherwise they should not be happy. Of course, there are a few other aspects also which are contributing to their happiness index. But almost 50,00,000 rupees per annum. And why our per capita income is so low, even being one of the greatest economies, is the population that we have. Right? Friends, these countries have a very extremely low population. All these developed countries which I have talked about, they have a population anywhere ranging between 45 to 50 lakh. See, 50 lakh population. Australia is 2 times bigger than India. And you know what is its population? 2.5 crore. 2.5 crore. And what's the population of India? Almost 130 crores. Right? That is the situation that we are facing our economy today. Going through a strange economic position. Now, how does it reflect in Indian economy? Global picture, right? Even if the economic size is less than India, क्योंकि पॉपुलेशन बहुत कम है, पर कैपिटल इनकम इज मोर. व्हाट इट हैपेंस इन इंडियन टर्म्स, इंडिया में अपनी इकोनॉमी बहुत अच्छी चल रही है, बहुत आगे से चल रही है, राइट? जीडीपी बहुत अच्छा बढ़ने वाला है. वुड इट ब्रिंग हैप्पीनेस? वुड दैट जीडीपी ब्रिंग हैप्पीनेस? आई डाउट. इन इंडियन स्ट्रक्चर, स्पेशली इन आवर कंट्री, द सिचुएशन इज लिटिल डिफिकल्ट, सिचुएशन इज लिटिल डिफरेंट. एंड द मेन हर्डल इन दिस डाउट, और मेन द हर्डल इन दिस प्रोसेस इज our unequal distribution of wealth, right? Hindi mein hum jise aarthik vishamta kehte hain, and in typical layman words, gareeb aur ameer ke beech ki doori, right? Friends, do you know India is one of the worst countries as far as that unequal distribution of wealth is concerned. This is second from the bottom, worst unequal distribution of wealth. 1% Indians possess 53% wealth of India. Can you imagine? 1% Indians possesses 53% wealth of India. You know, the only wealth of Ambani, Mukesh Ambani himself, is more than GDP of 19 countries. 19 countries GDP is less than his wealth. And that's how our wealth is got distributed. Right? Unfortunately, this was the seen few days back, few years back, that rich is becoming richer and poor are becoming poorer. But the best part and the exciting, interesting part is situation is slowly changing. Government and people collectively putting all the efforts in reducing this gap between poor and rich people. You know, government putting a lot of efforts towards this. They are trying a lot of different way to make a good upbringing of this poor people. Right, few schemes like electricity to all the people, medical facilities, banking, bringing them into the banking mainstream. You must have heard about Jan Dhan Yojana, right? It really impacted a lot for these people. Creating rural infrastructure to a great level so that the producers they produce in their villages, it can come to the market, it can come to cities and it can sell. You know, making easy loans available at cheaper rates. These are the different measures government is taking to reduce this gap between rich and poor. You know, I read something very beautiful in a magazine, friends. It's a responsibility of every good human being to earn a lot of money. It's responsibility of every good human being to create a lot of wealth. Why? Because good human being will spend their money on good causes. And the whole money will get circulated in the hands of good people. You must have heard of charity that Tata's and Azim Premji does. Friends, Tata Group, 75% of their earning, approximately 75% of their earning, they spend in a philanthropic activities. Azim Premji, close to 25,000 to 30,000 crore rupees every year, you know, spend on charities. And why this business? I just read in a newspaper in Pune, there was a businessman in Pune, and his daughter's wedding was there, and it was typical big fat Indian wedding, you know. And a lot of money was supposed to be wasted in those processes. He took a decision, he convinced his family, he convinced boy's family that we will not waste this money. With this money, we construct houses and we'll distribute it free to the poor people. Right? So instead of wasting that money on a wedding of daughter, they constructed houses and distributed it to poor people. All of us heard about that businessman in Gujarat who distributed cash to his employees. Right? So, photo wagera hame WhatsApp pe kahin pe dekha rahega. Good human beings has a responsibility to earn a lot of money. Right? And another advantage India has in reducing that gap between rich and poor is its human resource capital. Friends, in India, 65% of our population is less than 35 years old. 65%. And it is the best in the whole world. By 2020, average age of Indian would be 29 years. Average age of Indian by 2020 would be 29 years. And if you compare the same with China, it is 38 years. And Japan, the average age by next 2 years would be 48 years. So you can imagine the kind of opportunities India is going to have in the coming future. Right? I would strongly say that it's a responsibility of every person sitting in this auditorium. In coming years, it's a responsibility of all of you to earn huge money, create lot of wealth, grow exponentially wealth, and in the process, help many enough people to grow along with you. It's not about how much wealth you have created at the end of it. It's about how many lives you have created in the process. Right? So it's responsibility of all of us to create lot of wealth, to earn lot of money. Right? At the end, I would say one sentence and with that I'll conclude it. As long as we work a lot collectively with government and with volunteers about reducing the unequal wealth distribution in the country, ya arthik vishamta kam karne ki aur jitna zyada hum log kaam karenge utna hi zyada per capita income bhi badhega, apna GDP bhi badhega, and in the whole process apna happiness index bhi badhega. Thank you, friends. Thank you so much. Thank you.